And so now we're going to attempt to draw Anti Venom. This was a suggestion by another YouTuber called Kieran Baines, which I'll link to in the description and on here somewhere on the video screen, which you'll see somewhere here. So I'm going to attempt to draw this character that I don't really know from the comics because I haven't really, you know, bought any Spider-Man comics for a good few years. But I used to remember like Venom and Carnage, but Anti-Venom's something totally different, which I'll just have to look up. I think it's the same character like Eddie Brock, but who was Venom, but other than that, I'm not too sure. But anyway, I've looked up a few pictures online, and so we're going to start to, you know, draw Anti-Venom. Sketch. The thing about Venom and Carnage is the head designs are usually like some variation, you know, particularly around the eyes. Black sort of eye designs. Sketching the eyes there. I think he's got like spikes on his shoulders there, and there's like a spider design on the chest, which will just rough in, you know, quickly. This type of character who's wearing this one of these alien symbiote type costumes. Really, I'll have to start reading some of these Spider-Man books. I used to like it when I used to get the Venom, you know, Spider-Man comics. And you know, I used to have all the early appearances. Well, I've still got all the old comics. I'll have to dig them out sometime. You know, I'm 33. I still like my comics. So we're drawing this, you know, figure. Obviously, again, like the legs will just like tail off, so I'll only draw the top portions of the leg there. So it's like a white or grey type character. Which is sort of like the opposite of like the black blue of Venom. You know, so that's why I suppose it's called Anti-Venom. sketching the, you know, a little bit of hands there, or claws. You know, which we can finalise later on. And sketch the other arm in. In fact, like most of my other videos, I might do a close-up head sketch. Well, in fact, I've already done it, but I just need to edit it. Yeah, but I'll do it as like a Halloween, part of my Halloween series, might as well. Like a Halloween mask. Let's turn it into one of them. Just work on that spider design last, because that's the, I'd say that's the most difficult part. Just working on a lot of this muscle mass and just making sure it's all okay. And now we can, you know, really go back and start to work on this spider design. Try and straighten it out slightly. Look near enough even. That's why I'm darkening the, you know, pencil lines now. Just go back to this head now. Really try and just bring about some sort of elements here. And work on these teeth. I think I've noticed with the pictures I've seen, it's got uneven like mass teeth, but so it's like black, sort of like carnage. So we just like that, and the small eyes. Spikes going on the bottom of his chin as well. What shade these in yet? I'll leave that to the inking stage. It'll look a lot better. Obviously you can change the shape of these eye markings just to suit the face. In more details now. As you can see, the drawing sort of starting to take shape. Side muscles and lines. Start to clean up these hands now, which looked quite rough to begin with. But got the rough idea there. So now we can work on the inking stage. So I've got like a gel ink pen here. Start to ink Now obviously I think I've missed out the body of that spider, but I'll just leave it as that. Doesn't have to be totally perfect because it's an alien symbiote thing and it moves and it can evolve, so that's my excuse. Start to shade it in with the ink pen. I'm going to go over the eyes. If you had some like white out pens or something like that, you could add little things over the eyes, and you know, I haven't got any of them yet. Or maybe like white paint, something like that. Teeth. Shit, them in exactly the same, really. Same way. Small details, and just shade the rest of the eye designs. Going over the all the outline of the figure. working quickly as well. You can take your time, it's entirely up to you. Using a gel ink pen, which isn't ideal, but I prefer to use them, you know, because they're quick and oftentimes they're cheap. So instead you can try and add more detail, you know, just to help, just add more detail really. And just work on the other hand. To this spider design, just quickly do the outlines. Again, this is a first attempt at a character that I don't really know much about, but after having drawn this, I think I want to check the comics out again. Work on them. Just the muscles there. Wanted, so we could I'll just use this calligraphy pen, not the thin end, I'll use the thick end, just to, you know, fill in these larger areas. go over the lines. And again, if you had like a white out pen, you could these marks in between, you know, just do that. Just do little lines, just to suggest some figure and form and stuff like that. Never actually use these calligraphy pens. Not for the purpose that was intended. Calligraphy. Oh, I don't have the patience. One day I will, but not today. So I just use these just to fill in, you know, large areas. Just as a separate inking tool, really. Start speeding this up now, so I'm not going to colour this in, I'm just drawing it, taking away some of the paper there, never mind. So finish his spiders his own, I'd say that, call it a day. Say that's near enough it for Anti Venom. I'll just move the camera so you can see it more clearly. And here we go. Anti Venom. Cheers now.